Hello everyone, Matt here. Vanilla MCreator is cool and all, but what if I told you that MCreator supports mods too? They are called plugins and allow you to do all sorts of new things like adding new workspace types, procedures, translations and much more. While you can create your plugins, downloading plugins made by our community is also an option. They allow you to create a variety of new things like fabric mods, mods for older versions like 1.12.2, custom animated mobs using GeckoLib and much more. The sponsor of this video is NordVPN. Follow the link in the description to support the channel and get 68% off your first purchase as well as 3 months free. Stick around till the end if you want to learn why this is useful for MCreator users and more. Now let's go back to the video. First, I'd like to talk a little bit about what plugins are in the first place. Simply put, they are mods for MCreator that allow you to alter, improve or extend what MCreator offers. That means that you can add new things like support for different Minecraft versions, as well as various mod loaders like Forge or Fabric. Furthermore, you can add support for server-side plugin loaders like Spigot and less complex mod types like Resource Pack templates for various Minecraft versions. You can also add new procedure blocks as well as procedure templates. Note that this can make the procedure editor cluttered, however, this isn't a big issue since MCreator now has a search bar since the last update. Plugins also allow you to add support for other mod APIs like GeckoLib, Just Enough Items, Tinker's Construct API and much more. In addition to that, you can use them to add translations into languages that may not yet be supported by MCreator's core, or you can opt in to help translate MCreator on crowding. I'll leave a link to that in the description. All this is possible because MCreator is plugin driven by default. This means that most of MCreator's core is a built-in plugin that adds support for most of the features we all love. Now we know what plugins are all about, so let's open MCreator and explore our community's creations. On the workspace selector, click on the preferences button. Afterwards, search for the manage plugins tab located at the very bottom of the setting category list on the left. Here, you can see which plugins are currently installed and loaded, as well as their ID, version number, and sometimes its authors. To load new plugins, click on the Load Plugin button, search for the plugin you want to install and hit Open. To explore the public plugin library on the MCreator's website, click the Explore Plugins button. It opens the MCreator's website on the pages dedicated to plugins created by both the developers and the community. So far, we learned what plugins are, what they can do, how to install them, and how to find them, but haven't seen them in action or how to use them. In the next few minutes, I'll show you how to install some of the most popular and useful plugins used by the community. Note that some parts may repeat themselves, which is intentional so that everyone can follow along without the need to jump between sections of this video. First, let's install support for fabric mods. As you can see, fabric mod type already exists as a workspace type, but due to the lack of an integrated code generator, it's grayed out, so we need to install a plugin. This plugin has been created and maintained by some of the most active community developers like Boogie Monster, Guldorion and Crispy Chips. It has recently been updated, so I can find it at the top of the plugins list, but note that this might be different at the time you're watching this tutorial, so make sure to check other pages as well. Open the plugins page, and at the bottom, download the latest version of the generator, which at the time of making this video is version 1.0.0 pre-release 6. Since this is for a newer version of Minecraft than the one MCreator currently supports, we'll also need the cloth commons from Guldorion to make sure it supports as many features as possible. Now, we open the plugin manager, click Load Plugin, find the downloaded plugins and open them. You can now see the loaded generator and plugin on the plugin list. Click Save and to make sure everything works properly, restart MCreator. Now we can create a new workspace. On the left side, you can see that the fabric workspace type is no longer grayed out. The selected generator is now Minecraft Fabric for 1.16.3, which means that everything is working correctly. Note that at the moment, the plugin doesn't support all mod elements, which you can see in the generator info section. That doesn't mean that you cannot use it, but some mod elements might be disabled. The plugin is under active development, so in the future, it will most likely support other features as well. Now name your workspace, I'll call it My Fabric Mod, and use MCreator just like you would normally. Oh, and by the way, a sub to the channel would be astounding. Similarly to the Fabric plugin, you can also add support for Spigot plugins. The plugin is mostly developed by Guldorion and is still under heavy development, so many things still need to be added. It recently received an update, so it now supports the latest MCreator version as well. If you feel like contributing to the project, you can always help them out by going on their GitHub. To install it, download it from the MCreator's website, install it in the preferences under the Manage Plugins section using the Load Plugin button. Restart the program and create a new workspace. Now on the left, select Spigot Server Plugin, name it to your likings and start working on your Spigot plugin. If you wish to work on a less recent Minecraft version that isn't supported by the MCreator core anymore, you can search the plugin library and you might as well find your desired version of Forge or Datapex. Note that these generators are official but aren't supported by the developers anymore, because we, simply put, cannot afford to maintain all the versions at the same time. This means that some features from the newer versions of MCreator might be missing, but don't let that scare you, because you can still do a lot of things with those. Note that much like most of the other plugins, you can help develop this one too, by following the Git link in the description. Using this trick, I'll show you how to create mods for one of the most requested Minecraft versions, 1.12.2. Open the plugin page and search for the Minecraft Forge 1.12.2 mod generator. Scroll to the download section of this page and download the latest version that supports your current MCreator version. Since the latest release of MCreator at the moment of recording is 2020.5, I'll download the version 2.3.1. Now install it using the Plugin Manager tab in the Preferences and restart MCreator to make sure all the changes are in effect. Now create a new workspace of type Forge and open the version selector. You will now find 1.12.2 listed as a generator option. As you can see, some features like functions aren't supported in this version, but don't get too confused by the percentages on element lists, since they are compared to the latest supported Minecraft version and may misrepresent how much of the said version is supported. After selecting the version, name your workspace and start working on your mod like you usually would. Plugins also allow you to add new procedure blocks to MCreator. Some of the most known plugins for this are DTM's toolkit attributes for managing entity attributes by Drop the Mac, who also created a neat plugin making tool that we'll talk about later. Then we have the simple RNG plugin by someone else, as well as the ArrayList and Date Calendar Procedure plugins by Goldorion that are also supported by his Fabric and Spigot plugins. In this tutorial, I'll focus around ArrayList, but others should work with a similar approach. First, we download it from the MCreator's plugin list and make sure we download the latest version for the matching version of MCreator. Currently, this is the latest version 1.1. Much like for the previous ones, open Preferences and install the plugin from the Plugin Manager, as well as restart MCreator to make sure every change is applied. Now open the workspace where you want to use these procedures, and you'll notice that when working on procedures, you can find a new category called ArrayList. This means that we installed the plugin successfully. Note that not all plugins add custom tabs, so you might want to check other categories before reporting bugs to the plugin developers. One more thing to note is that after using procedure blocks from plugins, you will be unable to edit the procedures that use the elements from the plugin on installations without it. It may also cause errors in other cases, so make sure that you always install the plugin when working on that workspace afterwards. One more thing that plugins allow you to do is adding library support for third-party APIs like Patchouli, Just Enough Items, Curious and Tinker's Construct API using the More APIs support by Crispy Chips, but it currently doesn't support the latest MCreator, so I can't show you how to install it. You can, however, add support for GeckoLib using the Feather's GeckoLib plugin by Itay Feather that allows you to create super cool animations for your mobs. You install it using the same method as any other plugin by going in the Plugin Manager in the Preferences, opening the plugins and restarting the program. In addition to that, we also need to open our workspace settings and enable GeckoLib API external API. If you want to learn how to use it, there is a great video by KazFPS that explains the entire process in detail and creates some cool looking animations. I'll link their video in the description. Plugins also allow you to add translations in MCreator. You install them just like any other plugin and the translations will appear in the language selector. Since MCreator includes most of the community made translations, there is little to no need for them, but it's still an option if you want to add your own language or want to try out the translations before the next update is released. If you wish to help translate MCreator in your native language, you can always do that on MCreator's Crowdin. I'll also link it in the description. In case you want to create a custom plugin, a community member that goes by the name Drop the Mac created a plugin maker that helps you get started with plugins with a very user-friendly interface and an easy-to-understand workflow. Check out the DTM's Toolkit Plugin Architect on MCreator's forums. You can also give Goldorion's MCR Plugin Creator a try and see which one you prefer for yourself. Much like for everything else, I'll link them in this video description. Now I'd like to talk a little bit more about this video's sponsor NordVPN. NordVPN allows you to teleport anywhere in the world with only a few clicks from any country, including countries like China and the Middle East. This is super useful when you want to access content restricted or blocked in your region, like watch movies you previously weren't able to on Netflix or listen to music blocked in your country on Spotify. It can also come in handy when using MCreator in areas where one or more third-party plugins we use are blocked, as well as on school networks where Minecraft might be unavailable. Furthermore, NordVPN protects all your data, so it's perfect to use on public Wi-Fi networks like school or library networks. Using public Wi-Fi access points unprotected opens you up to risks like losing your login credentials or even credit card information. It's one of the best VPN services out there with no bandwidth or data limits. NordVPN uses only the most secure protocols and can be used on up to 6 devices simultaneously. You can install it on anything from your smartphone, laptop, or even your smart TV. They are currently offering a Christmas deal you can access using the link in the description to support the channel and get 68% off your first purchase as well as 3 months completely for free. They have a risk-free 30-day money-back guarantee, so in case you don't like what they offer anymore or simply change your mind, they have your back. Thanks for watching this tutorial. I hope you learned something new that might help you create better mods. Videos like this take a lot of time to make, so a sub to the channel would be greatly appreciated. If you don't want to miss the latest MCreator related news and tutorials, turn on the notifications, like for more content like this, and comment with suggestions down below. Have a nice day and happy modding!